Okay, students, so we will do the questions of TPP 003. So pehla jo question hai, that is all about molality. The molality of urea solution in which 0.01 gram of urea is added to 0.300 decimeter cube of water at STP is. Okay, so they have given a simple question. They have only asked you to find molality. All right, to find molality, what is the information that is required? Since this has come in the mostly in the MCQ pattern, you have to be faster with this question. But anyways, we will take a full approach. So what is the weight given? The weight given for urea is 0.01 gram. Okay, 0.01 gram. Okay, the weight given for urea is 0.01 gram. Okay, then what is the molar mass of urea? Molar mass of urea kitna hota hai? You should always know, students, that the molar mass of urea is 60 gram per mole. Okay, so it is 60 gram per mole. Okay, weight of urea is provided, molar mass of urea is provided, number of moles of urea can also be taken out. What is the number of moles? Weight of urea divided by molar mass of urea. So it is nothing but 0.01 divided by 60. All right, so number of moles of urea we can determine this way. Now we need to actually find molality. Molalities nikalne se pehle, there is one information that what is the volume of water that is taken? 0.3000 decimeter cube. 1 decimeter cube ka value kitna hota hai in terms of liter? It is always 1 liter. Theek hai? 1 liter ya 1000 ml. So what is the value of 0.300 decimeter cube? 0.3 decimeter cube is equal to 0.3 liter is equal to 300 milliliter. This is the volume of water. Okay, this is the volume of water. Okay, so this is the volume of water. The volume of water to hum log ko mil chuka hai 300 ml, but then what is the weight of water? Weight of water is equal to density of water into volume of water. Theek hai? Because density is weight by volume. So weight will be density into volume. So density kitna ho jayega? You have to remember this, student. Very, very important statement. Density of water is always, density jo hoga, that is always 1 gram per ml. Okay, 1 gram per ml. So 1 kilo per liter, so 1 gram per ml. So it is 1 into, what is the volume of water? It is 300. So it is nothing but 300 gram. Correct. Now you have number of moles of urea, you have weight of water, which is actually the solvent present. Now you can easily determine molality. So what will be the molality? Molality will be number of moles of urea divided by weight of water, and if it is taken in ml, agar isko ml mein le le into 1, oh sorry, this is not a ml particularly, this is in gram. Okay, if it is in gram, then I have to multiply 1000 over it. So number of moles of urea, what is the number of moles of urea? Number of moles of the urea will be, already we had determined that number of moles of urea kitna tha. It was given weight 0.01 divided by 60 divided by 0.0 divided by what is in gram. It will be 300 gram into 1000. Okay, so what is the correct answer? Molality is equal to 0.01 divided by 300 into 60 into 1000. So this gives you a correct answer of, so this gives an answer of 0.00055. So if you just change it into some kind of scientific notation, it will become 5.55 into 10 to the power minus 4 mole per kg. Correct. So the correct answer is option C. Okay, done. So let us move on to the next question. So what is the next question? So next question will be, let us go through. The vapor pressure of two liquids P and Q is 80 and 60. That is the pure vapor pressure. P naught of P is 80 torr and P naught of Q is 60 torr. Okay. Then the total vapor pressure obtained by mixing 3 mole of P and 2 mole of Q. Okay. So number of moles of P is 3 mole. Number of moles of Q is equal to 2 mole. Correct. Therefore, mole fraction of P is equal to number of moles of P divided by number of moles of P plus number of moles of Q. So ye kitna aa jayega value? It will be 3 divided by 3 plus 2. It is going to give you 0.6. What is the value of Q then? It will be 1 minus 0.6. That is equal to 0.4. Okay. So therefore, total pressure kya ho jayega? According to which law? For students who have not done this till now, I have not taught in all my to all my students this topic. So sooner or later you'll find it. It'll come very soon. This is according to Raoult's law. Okay. This is according to Raoult's law. You'll get Raoult's law in the next class most probably. So it will be total pressure will be given by P pressure of P naught A mole fraction of A plus P naught. Okay, now I cannot put A here because it has two different components, P and Q. So P and P, this will be Q and X of Q. So iska value kitna ho jayega? It will be 80 into mole fraction. What is the mole fraction? Mole fraction kitna ho jayega? Mole fraction will be, it is already determined, 0.6 plus P naught Q. P naught Q is 60 into 0.4. So if you do the calculation, it will come to be 72 torr. So this is our correct answer. Option A, 72 torr. Is it okay? Let us move on to question number 3. This is actually a part of question number 2 only. So we have done question number 2. Ab hum log kya dekhenge? Question number 3 ko dekhenge. Is it okay? So let us move on to question number 3. What is the molarity? Molarity nikalne diya hai. What is the molarity of 0.2 normal H2SO4? Is it okay? So there is a simple relationship between molarity and normality. That is, normality is equal to n factor into molarity. Okay, so what is normality? What is n factor over here? Because koi reaction diya nahi hai, so no worries at all. Just dekho kya component hai, it's an acid. Acid ka kya dekha jata hai? It's basicity. Simply check the number of hydrogen it has. Since no reaction is given, this is your advantage. Just check the number of hydrogen. So it is having 2 hydrogen, so n factor ho jayega 2. We need to find what? We need to find molarity. Okay, normality kitna diya hua hai? 0.2. So molarity will be 0.1 mole per liter. Okay, so this is your correct answer, option D. Moving on to the next question, question number 4. Okay, question number 4 mein kya bataya gaya hai? You can see that 6.02 into 10 to the power 20 molecules of urea are present in 100 ml of its solution. The concentration of the solution is, okay, what is the concentration of the solution? So what is the given number of particles? Number of moles of urea. Kaise nikale? Number of moles of urea is equal to given number of particles, given नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल्स डिवाइडेड बाय एवोगैड्रोस नंबर. ओके, गिवन नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल्स, व्हाट इज द गिवन नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल्स? 6.02 इंटू 10^20 डिवाइडेड बाय एवोगैड्रो नंबर, 6.02 इंटू 10^23 विच इज 10^-3 मोल. ठीक है, दिस इज आवर नंबर ऑफ मोल्स. क्लियर? ऑल राइट. Now what we need to determine is molarity. I'm just using this space, okay? So molarity ko nikalna hai. Kyun pata chala molarity? Because simply see the units, capital M means molarity. Molarity or molar, okay? So it is number of moles of urea divided by volume of the solution. What is the volume of solution? If it is in ml, then into 1000 you need to write. सो नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ यूरिया कितना हो जाएगा? 10^-3, 10^-3 इंटू 1000 डिवाइडेड बाई वॉल्यूम. वट इज द वॉल्यूम? 100 ml. इज इट ओके? सो 10^-3 इंटू 1000, इट इज कैंसलिंग ईच अदर. सो द वैल्यू इज 0.01 मोल पर व्हाट? मोल पर केजी. सो सॉरी, मोल पर लीटर. ओके, मोल पर लीटर. सो दैट इज आवर मोलैरिटी. इसको हम लोग मोलैरिटी बोलेंगे. सो द करेक्ट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज बी, 0.01 मोलर. ओके, मोल पर लीटर. डन, होपफुली. ऑल राइट, देख लेते हैं नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज 138 ग्राम्स ऑफ इथाइल अल्कोहल इज मिक्स्ड विथ 72 ग्राम्स ऑफ वाटर. ठीक है, द रेशियो ऑफ मोल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ वाटर टू अल्कोहल, अल्कोहल टू वाटर इज. ठीक है, सो दिस इज अ वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन. इट हैज नथिंग इन इट. नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ इथाइल अल्कोहल, लेट मी कंसिडर इथाइल अल्कोहल एज ई एंड वाटर इज डब्ल्यू. सो नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ इथाइल अल्कोहल इज गिवन वेट ऑफ द सैंपल. वट इज द गिवन वेट ऑफ द सैंपल? यू कैन क्लियरली सी इट इज 138 ग्राम डिवाइडेड बाई मोलर मास ऑफ इथाइल अल्कोहल. बाई द वे, वट इज द मोलर मास ऑफ इथाइल अल्कोहल? इथाइल अल्कोहल का फॉर्मूला हो जाता है C2H5OH. सो मोलर मास ऑफ इथाइल अल्कोहल विल बी कार्बन, 2 इंटू 12 प्लस 5 इंटू 1 प्लस 16 प्लस 1. ओके, सो इट इज 24 प्लस 5 प्लस 16 प्लस 1. सो इट इज 17 प्लस 5, 22 प्लस 24, दैट इज 46 ग्राम पर मोल. ओके, सो दिस इज द मोलर मास ऑफ ethyl alcohol. So great, so we'll have to find out 46 gram per mole. Okay, so now let us do this question. It is given as 138 gram divided by 46, so it gives you an answer of 3 mole. Okay, so number of moles of ethyl alcohol is 3 mole. What is the number of moles of water? Number of moles of water will be given weight. What is the given weight? 72 gram divided by molar mass. Molar mass of water, everybody knows, it is 18 gram per mole, right? So 18 kitna ja ho jata hai? 18 4 ja. Okay, so 18 4 moles. Therefore now what do we need to find? We need to find mole fraction of what? Ethyl alcohol is equal to number of moles of ethyl alcohol divided by number of moles of ethyl alcohol plus number of moles of water. So what is number of moles of ethyl alcohol? It is 3 mole divided by 3 plus 4, so that is equal to 3/7. What about mole fraction of water? That is number of moles of water. I don't need to find this anyways. Why I don't need to find this? Easy peasy, because we can simply do it by वाटर इज इक्वल टू 1 माइनस एक्स ई, सो इट इज 1 माइनस 3 बाई 7 विच इज नथिंग बट 4 बाई 7, ओके विच इज नथिंग बट 4 बाई 7. तो 4 बाई 7 होने के साथ साथ व्हाट हैपेंस, 4 बाई 7 होने के साथ साथ इट बिकम्स, व्हाट इज द रेशियो गोइंग टू बी, द रेशियो इज गोइंग टू बी एक्स इज टू एक्स डब्ल्यू, द रेशियो इज गोइंग टू बी व्हाट, इट इज गोइंग टू बी 3 बाई 7 इज टू 4 बाई 7 विच इज नथिंग बट 3 इज टू 4. सो दिस इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन, क्लियर, होपफुल इट इज क्लियर फॉर एवरी वन. So, all right, let us move on to the next question. Okay, students, so let's do question number 6. H2S is a toxic gas used in qualitative analysis. So, definitely you are going to come across H2S gas in class 12 laboratory. And definitely you are not going to forget it so soon, okay? If something you are going to remember from the chemistry lab, definitely it will be the smell of H2S. If solubility of H2S in water at STP is 0.195 mole per kg, what is the value of KH? So KH ka value kitna hota hai? That they have simply asked. Now this is a very intelligent question. This is a very simple question at the same time. It does not have much details to the question. Very, it's a like two line question. But many students might get some like challenges while doing this question, though it is very very easy, okay? So let us start. Kya hoga is question mein? So first of all, what is mentioned in the question is the molality of the solution H2S. So it is 0.195 mole of H2S is present in 1000 gram of the solvent. So what is the solvent over here? Of water, definitely. ठीक है, तो number of moles of H2S is actually 0.195 mole. And weight of the solvent, okay, rather than doing that, I'll just, because solute ko hum log small b pakadte hain, so I'll just use that, okay? So weight of the solvent is how much? It is 1000 gram of water. All right, so what is the number of moles of water, number of moles of solvent? It is the weight of the solvent divided by molar mass of the solvent. So exactly how much is that? So ye kitna ho jayega? It will be 1000 divided by molar mass. So what is the molar mass? Molar mass of water is 18. So what is the value? It is 55.5 mole per kg. So this is the number of moles of water. Okay? Clear? So all right, now what we need to find, so number of moles of b is the solute, that is H2S, okay? This b stands for H2S over here and a stands for water over here. Now what we need to determine is Henry's law, KH nikalne apne ko. So here two important information is also given. This STP ka meaning kya hota hai? Standard temperature and pressure. From here, you get two informations. What is the temperature over here? It is 273 Kelvin. And what is the pressure? Pressure is equal to 180 m. Okay. So pressure and temperature is mentioned in the question. Great. Now, therefore, partial pressure of the gas H2S is equal to KH into mole fraction of the gas H2S. So H2S is our B, right? So KH into, what is this? I can keep it as 1. 1 ATM hota hai na? So that's why. So mole fraction of H2S will be number of moles of H2S divided by number of moles of H2S plus number of moles of solvent water. So KH apne ko nikalna hai. KH will be NB plus NA divided by NB which is nothing but you are getting how much. It will be NB is 0.195 plus 55.5 divided by 0.195. okay, so the correct value of this answer is, so it is going to be 285.61 ATM. ओके, तो मैंने के एच का वैल्यू निकाला, वो ए टी एम में है. दैट्स ऑल राइट इफ इट्स अ क्वेश्चन ऑन द बोर्ड्स, बट इन दिस एंट्रेंस बेस्ड क्वेश्चन द यूनिट इज इन बार. ओके, सो आई मस्ट पिक दिस क्वेश्चन, पिक दिस सॉल्यूशन एंड कन्वर्ट इन टू बार. सो 285.61 ATM, इफ आई नीड टू कन्वर्ट इन बार, आई हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई ए फैक्टर 1.013 बार, बिकॉज 1 ATM का वैल्यू जो होता है दैट इज़ 1.013 बार होता है. इज इट ओके? सो अल्टीमेटली व्हाट इज़ द आंसर टू दिस, इट इज़ 285.61 इनटू 1.013, दैट इज़ गोइंग टू बी 289.3 बार. Okay, so I have got an answer 289.3 bar, but as you can see, none of the option actually matches with my answer. So in that case, I will go to the nearest available option. So option D will be the correct answer. Okay, next question. So all right, let us go over to the next question. This is Henry's law constant for molality of methane in benzene at 298 Kelvin is 4.27 into 10 to the power 5 millimeter mercury. So KH ka value kya diya hai? It is 4.27 into 10 to the power 5 millimeter mercury. So this unit can be anything. Ye unit jo ho sakta hai, pressure ka unit hai. It may be millimeter mercury, or it may be atmospheric pressure ATM, or it may be bar, it may be torr. Okay, so something like that. So just do not get confused over the different units of KH. Theek hai, to ye to ho gaya. Uske baad kya information hai? Find the mole fraction of methane in benzene at 298 Kelvin under 760 millimeter pressure. तो pressure कितना दिया गया है? Pressure of the gas is 760 millimeter mercury. तो क्या पूछा गया है? Simply they have asked you the value of what? They have asked you find mole fraction. You need to find the mole fraction. चलो ठीक है, निकाल लें हम लोग mole fraction applying Henry's law. What is Henry's law? So what does it actually gives? It is Henry's law kya ho jata hai? It is pressure of the gas is KH into mole fraction of the gas. I need to determine mole fraction of the gas. That will be PG divided by KH. What is the value of PG? It is 760 divided by 4.27 into 10 to the power 5. ठीक है, so it is going to be 0.00018. okay, so this is the mole fraction. You can see it's a very small amount. The quantity of methane in benzene is not very high, as you can see in the mole fraction. The concentration is very less. The maximum concentration is, however, that is possible is 1. Okay, so next question. How much oxygen is dissolved in 100 ml of water at 298 Kelvin if partial pressure of oxygen is 0.5 ATM and KH is given to be this much? Volume kitna diya gaya hai? 100 ml. Okay, partial pressure of oxygen kitna hai? It is 0.5 ATM. KH is given to be 1.4 into 10 to the power minus 3 mole per liter per ATM. So what they have actually asked is, how much is dissolved in 100 ml? ठीक है, निकाल लेंगे हम लोग. ओके, हाउ मच. सो यहाँ पे केएच का वैल्यू जो दिया है, केएच का यूनिट एक बार देखा जाए, इट इज़ मोल पर लीटर पर एटीएम. सो केएच का एक्चुअली बेस्ड ऑन यूनिट ऑफ केएच, बेस्ड ऑन यूनिट ऑफ केएच, यू विल आइदर यूज वन ऑफ द फॉर्मूलाज पी जी इज इक्वल टू के एच इन टू एक्स जी. ये कब यूज़ किया जाता है, जब के एच का यूनिट होगा इन टर्म्स ऑफ या तो ए टी एम होगा, या फिर सिर्फ बार होगा, या सिर्फ टॉर होगा, या फिर सिर्फ मिलीमीटर मरकरी होगा. इन दैट केस यू विल बी यूजिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर फार्मूला, नंबर वन. नंबर टू, द अदर फार्मूला इज सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ द गैस, दिस इज कंसनट्रेशन इज इक्वल टू के एच इन टू pressure of the gas. Is it okay? So this formula you will be using when KH has a unit of such type of unit, mole per liter per atm, and in place of this atm you can put bar, tor, millimeter mercury, anything. Okay, so which formula am I going to use right now? It is SG is equal to applying Henry's law ko apply kar dete hain. एस जी इक्वल टू के एच इन टू पी जी. ठीक है, के एच, वट इज़ के एच, द वैल्यू ऑफ के एच इज 1.4 इंटू 10 टू द पावर माइनस 3. सो वट इज़ द प्रेशर, प्रेशर इज 0.5. ओके, सो द सॉल्युबिलिटी, देयरफॉर सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ द गैस कितना होगा, इट विल बी 0.0007, देन इट विल बी मोल per liter. Okay, so what is the definition over here? It is 0.007 mole per liter. Now 1 liter mein kitna available quantity hai, it is 0.007. okay, so in that case only for 100 ml, how much will be soluble, that you need to find out. You can do it in unitary method also if you want, as simple as that. You can find any ways to do that. Okay, so in 1 liter, what is the amount that is available in 1 liter? That is 1000 ml oxygen dissolved is equal to 0.0007 mole. Therefore in 100 ml oxygen dissolved is 0.0007 divided by 1000 into 100. Okay, it will cancel. So it will be 0.00007 moles. So I'll just write, it is 7 into 10 to the power minus 5 mole. Okay. All right, so next question. What will be the molarity of 30 ml of 0.5 molar H2SO4 solution diluted to 500 ml? ठीक है, so we have to apply dilution law. Dilution law के हिसाब से what is the formula that we can apply? It is initial molarity into initial volume is equal to final molarity into final volume. This is the dilution law and we are applying dilution law. So ye kitna ho jayega, it is, what is the volume over here, it is 30 ml, right? What is the molarity, it is 0.5. what is the molarity over here, it is not mentioned. And what is the volume over here, it is 500 ml. okay, diluted to 500 ml, so it is diluted from 30 ml to, the volume is increased from 30 ml to 500 ml. So MF kya ho jayega, it will be 0.5 into 30 divided by 500, it will be 1000, and it is 3 by 100. Okay, 3 by 100 is 3 into 10 to the power minus 2 mole per liter. Okay, what will be the molarity of 30 ml of solution diluted to 500 ml. Okay, so the molarity will be, as mentioned, it is 30 3 × 10⁻², मोल पर लीटर। क्लियर एवरीवन? लास्ट क्वेश्चन, फाइंड द मोलैरिटी ऑफ मोलैलिटी ऑफ 648 ग्राम ऑफ प्योर वाटर। ठीक है, तो मोलैलिटी को कैसे निकालना चाहिए? मोलैलिटी इज इक्वल टू नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ सॉल्यूट डिवाइडेड बाय वेट ऑफ द सॉल्वेंट। इफ इट इज इन ग्राम देन यू नीड टू मल्टीप्लाई इनटू 1000। सो नंबर ऑफ मोल्स समटाइम्स मे बी रिटन एज नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ सॉल्यूट मे बी रिटन एज वेट ऑफ द सॉल्यूट इनटू मोलर मास ऑफ द सॉल्यूट डिवाइडेड बाय मोलर मास वेट ऑफ द सॉल्वेंट इनटू 1000। सो स्पेसिफिकली दे हैव मेंशनड फ्यू थिंग्स, 648 ग्राम इन दिस केस WB will be WA, so we are not taking anything. They have asked just about the molality, okay? So it will be simply 648 divided by molar mass of the solute. It is 18, okay? This will give you the number of moles and the weight of the solvent. Also, we have to take the same thing, 648 into 1000. So it is 55.5 mole per kg. Over. Now why it is weight of the solvent and weight of the there is nothing like weight of the solvent and solute over here, okay? There is nothing like that. So they have asked you just the weight, just the molality in terms of molality, they have asked you the same thing, okay? So thank you everyone. If you have any doubts regarding anything, then you can message me. Alright, so keep on practicing the DPPs. These DPPs are very important. As you practice, so the confidence will also increase. And these are simple questions. Practice this right now, and this will take you to more advanced level of question solving. Okay, so thank you everyone. Take care of yourself.